receiving it from the Queen. Peter Rodrigues, the cup for Southampton.
After we've beaten Bradford, you've got four teams left, which is Manchester United, who are the up-and-coming Doherty boys who are going to conquer the world, and Derby County, who have won the first division, and us and Crystal Palace, who are in the second division. Who do you want? You want Crystal Palace, and we go and get Crystal Palace. So, I mean, you know, you need a little bit of luck on the way. And that, we had a little bit of luck, but then we still, you know, we still did the business and got the results that took us through to play, obviously, Manchester United.
It turned out, you know, on the day it was pretty, it was a pretty even game. It wasn't probably the best game, but I just remember the pitch was pretty bumpy and pretty not particularly good to play on. But as luck went, it, you know, went our way really on that day.
So Peter Taylor of Crystal Palace gives this semi-final the first touch. Palace attacking the goal to our right, of course in that white chain strip of theirs, allowing Southampton to play in their normal strip of red and white stripes and black shorts.
We'd gone through each round and we had lucky breaks and things had gone well for us. And I don't know, I just think everybody was confident that we could win. I think, you know, we got to a point where we were always going in thinking we were going to get a victory, but again it's so close. Personally, I never really got worried or pressurised or anything like that beforehand. Probably the only time I ever did was at West Brom when we played at the Hawthorns. And that was the only time really I kind of got to me a bit. But after that, I didn't even the final. It was just great to be there, you know, and I was going to try and make the most of it.
It was tight. We knew they were useful because they were up the top of the second division. They were getting promoted into the first division. And they had Malcolm Allison as their manager with his, you know, flamboyance and his cigars and his big hats and whatever, and he took a good publicity stint, wasn't he? And it was going to be hard, and they had some good players. I mean, at the time Peter Taylor was playing for him, he played for England, the winger, he went to Tottenham, and so it was going to be hard. Anything's going to be hard when you get to the semi-final. It doesn't matter whether you play somebody from the fourth division or the world champions, it's going to be hard. And it was a hard game. And then we've nicked a goal.
Throw in on the right hand side, which I can't remember what it was. I can't remember who did it. Jimmy Mack, I think. I got it back from him. And I played a 1-2 with Ozzy, and he just knocked it in.
Gilchrist hit well. Goal!
I always remember in the interview afterwards. I think it was on the big match or whatever. And I just said to them that, you know, the opportunity arose to hit it for some reason, and that's what I did. I just hit as hard as I could, and it just literally, just like a dart, just literally went into the bottom left-hand corner. I thought, well, he's going to stop it, he's going to save it, but when he didn't, and the net just sort of, you could see the net bulged, and that's the... That's when I realised that it, and then the noise, and then that was it, elation, really. And I think once that had gone in, that was the, couldn't really see them coming back from that. And that sort of was the, again, really on the day, they had a couple of chances where they could have scored, but didn't. And we took ours and did. So it was our name was on it, really, to go through.
Down he goes, and I think it's a penalty, is it? Penalty given, or not? No, it's not. Thought for a moment he was running to that penalty spot. The linesman has come quickly onto the field to show them that it was just outside. No, he's given a penalty. He's given a penalty.
It was backwards and forwards. And then Mick fell over, as he normally did, and we get a penalty, and and I took the penalty. That was the first penalty I took. I think he missed a few, and a couple of others had took one now and again, and he'd missed a few, and I said, I'll take the penalties from now on, when we was talking, because I used to take them for Gillingham. So that was agreed. But it took a while to get one, you know, even though he fell over most games. It took us a while to get a penalty, and it happened to be that was the first one. And probably the worst I've took. Yeah, I would say it's the worst I've took. But I realised then that if I scored that bit, we would be going to Wembley. So I just blasted it.
And this really is the moment where he could settle everything now for Southampton. Peach versus Hammond. 2-0.
And I always placed my penalties, either one side or the other. I made my mind up before I ever got to the ball, and I'd never changed my mind. And I made my mind up that I'm going to blast it. That's what I did, and it went straight as a die.
But their day looks to be done now, as the referee again looks at his watch. And it's all over, and Southampton are through to Wembley, with goals by Paul Gilchrist, the man who only came on at the last moment, and David Peach from the penalty spot. Well, there are smiles everywhere. Ian Turner, the goalkeeper, is broadest of all. The fans have had a tremendous day up here from the South Coast. Southampton are through to the final, and as Palace go trooping off, he's going right down. In fact, all the Southampton players have gone down there to salute the Southampton supporters. And it's hard to know who's the more delighted, the players or the fans or Peter Osgood, who's helped to put Southampton through to the final on this, his old ground at Stamford Bridge. Scenes of tremendous joy.
I remember afterwards, Mick Shannon said he got interviewed in the changing room afterwards, and he said it was great. We've done well. We've got through to the final, but we've got to go and win it. And that was I think everybody wanted to do that, obviously.
And receiving it from the Queen, Peter Rodrigues, the cup for Southampton.